Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about the next subtopic, the types of soil. Previous class we will discuss about the how is soil formed. You know how is it soil formed? The breakdown of rock particle, the breakdown of rock particle by the action of water, air, wind, and climate. This is called weathering. You know, so this way only the soil is formed. You know, the naturally the big piece of rock is present in mountain. You know, the rock particle is present. So how is the rock particle is broken through that action of like the water and air and wind and climate. Okay, so this way only the rock particle is broken. So this is the one of the way the soil can form. Soil can form. So the soil is a very important for our human life because it's a inseparable. Okay, the most of the living organism like the earthworm, okay, and insect and plants, so even protozoa also it can live in that soil. And another important thing, so the soil is a very important for agriculture purpose. You know, the like the loamy soil, you know, so that is that soil is a top soil for growing plants. Okay, wow. So that what is the meaning of the soil means nothing but the soil means nothing but the mixture of rock particle, the mix of rock particle and humus, the mixture of rock particle and humus is known as called the soil. So that soil is mainly that the mixture of rock particle like the sand soil and the loamy soil and clay and silt, whatever. So the mixture of soil particle and humus. You know, humus means nothing but is a dead plant and animal. The humus means nothing but dead plants and animal. The plants and animals, that is called what, humus. So this humus is provided more nutrients. So this humus is provided more nutrients for the growing plants. Okay, well, the humus means nothing but, so you say dead plants and animals. So the dead plants and animals is naturally decomposed with the soil. So that soil can get the nutrients from the dead plant and animal. So that is called what? That is called humus. That is called humus. And the many of the living organisms like the protozoa and earthworm and insects and plant food also, it is a home for soil. Because the soil is inseparable in our life. The soil, it is inseparable for in our life. You know. And another one important thing, the parent rock. The parent rock. So the parent rock means like the sandy soil and clay soil is originated or formed that rock. That is called what? The parent rock. Like the sandy soil and clay soil of rock from this material. So that is called what? Parent rock. So the parent rock is nothing but, so like a sandy soil and clay soil and in some other soil also is made up of that rock or originated from rock, you know. So that is called the parent rock. That is called what? That is called the parent rock. Okay. And next we will discuss about the different kinds of the soil. Okay, wow. The first one, the sandy soil. First one, the sandy soil. So these kinds of soil is naturally has its greater proposition. So this kind of soil is has a greater proposition and it has the big particle is called the sandy soil. The first one, the sandy soil is a greater proposition. Greater the proposition of the big particle. Big particle. That is called the big particle. That is called what? Is the sandy soil. soil or bubbles also is present in kind of soil. Okay, what? And the particle size. Okay, what? The particle size that the soil size the 0.05 mm to 0.02 mm. Okay, what? 2.00 mm. Okay, wow. So the sand soil particle size 0.05 mm to 2 mm. So it is the size of the sand soil. The size of the sand soil. So these kinds of soil. Okay, wow. So these kinds of soil has its five lots. So these kinds of soil has five lots. And these kinds of soil has between the large space between that soil. So these kinds of soil has is between the large space between the large space for the soil surface. So for the soil surface. And these kinds of soil cannot close together. Okay, what? Cannot close together. So these kinds of soil it cannot close because some gap is there. So that gap is filled with gap. Okay, what? The space filled with gap. So that's why this sand soil cannot close together. So that's why these kinds of soil it cannot close together. Okay, what? Because of the space filled with air. And water can run quickly through the space between the sand particle. So water it can quickly drain. Okay, what? Because of that space. Okay, what? Water it cannot drain. Okay, what? The water can quickly drain through the space between the sand particle. Between the sand particle. And this kind of soil is very tent of light. There is the no weight. Okay, what? And this kind of soil can easy to dry. So this kind of soil can easy to dry. Easy na, you know, drier. Because the water cannot hold this kind of soil. Water cannot hold because of the air filled. The space will be there, so that's why we need to evaporate. So this soil looks like in the dry. Okay, what? And this soil, okay, this kind of soil is constructing a building and houses. So this kind of soil used to what? Constructing a building and factories in some other houses also. Okay, so this is about the sandy soil. This is about the sandy soil. And next one kind of soil is a clay soil. Then next one kind of soil what? Clay soil. Okay, what? So these kinds of soil has a fine particle. Okay, what? These kinds of soil has is a fine particle is relatively higher than is called the clay soil. So the clay soil is has a fine particle. So the fine particle means nothing but so these kinds of soil is a with the small size. Okay, wow. So these kinds of soil is located in the very the small size of soil. Okay, wow. The clay particle is much smaller packed tightly together, leaving little space for air. So this kind of soil is much small. Much is a smaller particle. The much is a smaller particle and leaving that space for air. Okay, ma. So this kind of size, you know, the size of this soil less than 0.05 mm. Okay, ma. So the grain soil size is a size the less than 0.05 mm, less than 0.05 mm. So this kind of soil is naturally hold the water. Okay, what? It hold the water. Hold the water capacity. Because so this soil is absorbed that and store the water. Hold the water. Because for that way, so this soil is very important. Okay, what? And here is the tiny gap between the bottle of clay. The tiny gaps between the particles of clay. The tiny particle means some gaps also is there. So the tiny particle between that clay. So the clay soil has less air. So these kinds of soil has that less air. The clay soil has the less air. Because you know the sandy soil has itself that the space fully that space covered with air or filled with air. Okay, wow. So that's why the water can quickly evaporate. You know, but that these kinds of soil, the clay soil has the less air. The clay soil has itself less air, but they are maybe they hold the more water than the sandy soil. So that's why these kinds of soil is always hold the water. Okay, wow. This kind of soil is always hold the water. Okay, so this is about the clay soil. And next one, the loamy soil. The next one, the loamy soil. So that this is a best top soil. So this is a best top soil. The best top soil. So that loamy soil is a best top soil for growing plant. Best top soil for growing plants. So this soil is mostly useful for growing plant because so this kind of soil, you know, the loamy soil has is a more humus. So this kind of soil has is a more humus. So that's why this kind of soil is very useful for growing plants. Okay, well. And the loamy soil is a mixture of sandy, mixture of the sandy and the clay soil. The mixture of land, mixture of the loamy soil is a mixture of the sandy and clay soil. Okay, but this kind of soil is mixture of the sandy and clay soil. Okay, but so this soil is very useful for the agriculture purpose. Okay, but so this soil is mostly useful for the agriculture. Because so this is a very good soil. So this soil can be used for the agriculture purpose. Because so this soil is naturally containing that more humus. So that's why this kind of soil is used for agriculture. Okay? And then next one, the silt. Okay, wow. So the silt occurs on the deposit of river bed. So gardeners present this kind of soil. So this kind of soil is a river bed. Okay, wow. So this kind of soil that represent a river bed. You know, like that riverside. You know, so riverside is deposited on the this kind of soil. So silt. So this kind of soil it has the fine particles. So these kinds of soil has the fine particles. So these kinds of soil has the fine particles. So the size of the silt particles between two of the sandy and clay. So this size, you know, the size is between that sandy soil and clay soil. So it is look like that good powder form. Okay, wow. So this size is between the clay and the humus. Okay, wow. The loamy soil is having that. So these kinds of soil also has the more humus. So these kinds of soil has the more humus. equal that. Loamy soil also it has the more humus. It has right to water holding capacity for the growth of plants. So it has the right capacity. Here given it has the right capacity to hold the soil. Right capacity to hold the soil. So that soil particle, the soil particle, the soil particles between 0.005 mm to 0.05 mm. This is very important. So what is the size of the silt? So the soil particle between that 0.005 mm to 0.05 mm. 0.005 mm to 0.05 mm. It is the size of the silt. It is the size of the silt. Okay, what is the size of the silt? So that is about the different types of soil. Okay, and the next one, the activities given in our books, the page of 99. Open it. So first you take some the different kinds of soil, get from the different places. First we will collect the different kinds of sample of soil like the sandy soil and the clay and silt and the loamy soil. Okay. And next what you do, next you pick and collect the pick pieces of pebbles and some you remove the pebbles and drop and glass plate, in some other unwanted materials also is present on the soil. You know, first you remove that unwanted material from the soil. Okay, and next to what you do, now the soil is ready. Now you have the good soil. Next, you add drop by drop of water. You know, the picture given that page of 100, you know, then see the picture again. You know, for example, now you take some the sandy soil. Or now you take the clay soil. Now what you do? You add the water, drop by drop, you add the water again. And add just enough water so that you are born. Okay, what? First you collect the sample and remove the unwanted things like stone and whatever is present, just you remove it. Then you add drop by drop of water and make it a ball size. And make it a ball size. You know the figure 100, you know the page of 100. And can be made from the bud, the same time should not be sticky. Try to make a ball. Okay, what? Try to make a ball size from that soil. On a flat surface, roll this ball into the seeder. Okay, what? And anything not to know. So the roll ball with the seeder shape. Next, you will make it a ring like structure. Then what you do? Then you make a ring like structure. Try to make a ring from this activity, like a cylinder. Repeat this activity with the other sample also. That the extent to which soil can be shaped to indicate is time. You know? So which kind of soil we can make it a ball, okay, and in some other tie side. Which kind of soil can you make like a clay soil only? You can make it a toys, okay, what? And in some other hot material also made it from the clay soil. So this soil is a clay soil is a used for making a toys as well as some material like the toys and pot also is made from this kinds of soil. Okay, what? So the different kinds of soil it can use it for different purpose. Okay, what? For example, the sand soil it can use it for fencing a building, and clay soil it can use it for making a toys and what? Toys and pot. And loamy soil is content. It is very good for the growing plant for the agriculture purpose. So the different kinds of soil we can use in the that different purpose in the human life. So that's why the soil is inseparable in our human life.